into our coverage inside the tunnel at the PPL Park, the US men's national team's first ever visit here. Very appropriate that they're back in Philadelphia, John. This was the scene of their send-off series finale against Turkey, that 2-1 victory back at the end of May that sent them on their way.
The other night at 4-2-3-1, tonight 4-3-3, the triangle. It's going to answer a lot of questions for Colombia. Well, a 4-4-2 situation and a great result the other night, 1-0 over Ecuador.
Yeah, it is a bit of a mystery, isn't it, Colombia, in many ways.
You know, from the last World Cup, here's a giveaway right here.
Yeah, Adu caught in possession and danger here for the U.S. It's Falcao on his way through, missing the shot, and Guzan was able to parry the rebound. What an opportunity for Colombia. Moreno was the second player to arrive on the scene, but Guzan equal to it. Yeah, it's fallen for Moreno. Falcao in support. Jones chipping away at him. Illegally, according to referee Roberto Garcia, with Falcao. It's Falcao takes it right into the wall. Still there for the taking, though. The header in the end, a tame one. Right into the arms of Guzan. It was Villafana. Guzan's booming clearance releases Jermaine Jones. Free kick was in his favour.
Now you see the Zuniga, the number 18, just clip his heels just enough.
Stuart Holden. Can he connect with Oguchi Onyewu again, as he did in Chicago? It's a good service, and it was Onyewu on the end of it. Claiming he was impeded, perhaps, trying to get on the end of that delicious delivery from Holden. But the halftime whistle has gone here. Not much to shout about, really, for either sets of supporters. Sam's Army and the Sons of Ben will have to wait, perhaps, for some second-half fireworks. It's 0-0 at halftime. Well, let's check in with our Gatorade Recover halftime substitutions, and it's a full bottle as well, four of them. Clint Dempsey replacing Brek Shea. Michael Parkhurst back in US national team action will replace Oguchi Onyewu. Parker's first cap since July of 2009. A debut as well, a second one of the night. Eric Lehigh will come in to replace Jonathan Spector, and Eddie Johnson goes in for Maurice Adu. So four new faces, John, and presumably a tactical switch as well. We're going to see how Johnson and Altidore do together up front in the second half.
Well, I remember he was pushing so hard to get ready for the US in the summer.
First shot on goal, isn't it, for the US?
I can't remember a save that Farid Mondragon has had to make up until that point. Holden at least making him work. And the US score from a corner on Saturday night against Poland. They don't have the goal scorer, Oguchi Onyewu, on the pitch anymore. He's getting on the end of this. It's a good header. Not quite down enough from Clarence Goodson, who climbed well to meet it. Parkhurst. Couldn't maintain possession. Moreno latched onto it. Looking for a target in the middle. Moreno's cross! Headed back across the face of goal. Options arriving. This is Ramos. He's got the better of Lehigh. But Parkhurst is there to deal with the threat. At the expense of a corner, though, it'll be Colombia's first.
Seattle Sounders very hot right now. We see a foul being committed on Eddie Johnson in the midfield.
Now with Stuart Holden gone, it's Benny Failharbour to take the set pieces. He's released Josie Altidore, but it's not going to count. The Sons of Ben and Sam's Army celebrating, but a very quick flag up on the near side. Not quite materialised. This is an attack that's materialised now for Colombia and Valencia. It's Cuadrado. Jones.
And a yellow card as well. It's just a referee. Does it just clip him here? He offsets him here. You see that? It's a piece of the ball. I didn't see much of the foul.
Well, perhaps the counter-attack may be on. Jermaine Jones. Nice-looking ball for Josie Altidore. Help arriving in the middle. And they'll have to settle for the corner. That Jones-Altidore connection again.
The Sam's Army and the supporters behind. They want to see a goal go in for the U.S.
Dempsey trying to get underneath it, but Mondragon with a comfortable claim.
Definitely the country, a lot of pressure to get back to the World Cup and represent at the highest level.
Jones on to Dempsey. Encouraging build-up.
Eric Lichaj delivering a great cross for Altidore. Oh, a header either side of Mondragon. And that would have been the US in front. As it was, it went right to him. Jones with Bradley arriving. And he was fouled. There is going to be one last opportunity to win it from a set piece.
Clarence Goodson being one of those targets in a wide area.
Quite get enough elevation on it. It was dealt with by Yepes, and that proves to be the final moment of the game. It is indeed a goalless draw. Jermaine Jones, Germany Jones, as the US fans have started to call him, playing a major role in this scoreless draw.